Hi guys, welcome to the 9th episode of Hit the Blocks. Today we're going to study two different ways to instantiate an inherited smart contract. Okay, so jump to your terminal and in your project folder we're going to initiate the truffle command. So truffle init, and it's going to create these folders, and then we're going to create our smart contract. So we're going to execute the truffle create contract and then the name of the contract, and this time we're going to call our contract my bet. Okay, and then in the contract folder you should see a my bet contract. Okay, so now we're going to open our text editor, and that's what you should see. So we're going to define a contract my bet that inherits from another contract, which is a generic bet contract. So now let's define this bet contract. So contract bet, open the curly braces, and this contract bet is going to behave differently depending on the value of an internal bet type variable. So we're going to define this variable, which will be an integer. So uint bet type, and this variable is going to be assigned in a constructor. So constructor that I define with a function keyword, and here it's going to be the same name as the contract. And we're going to pass to this constructor an integer bet type prefixed by an underscore, and we're going to simply assign this bet type variable to our internal bet type variable like this. Okay. So you might want to ask me, why would we want to do this? Well, it could be the case that this generic smart contract behaves in a different way depending on the value of bet type. So for example, if bet type is set in a certain way, maybe that some operations are allowed. But if bet type is set in another way, maybe some other operations are allowed. Okay. So now we have our bet contract, but the problem is that the way that we inherit from this contract, we don't pass this value bet type here, line 6. So what I will do is I will add parentheses around the bet contract here. So line 10, when I define my bet is bet, I'm going to add those parentheses, and I'm going to pass an arbitrary value to the constructor of the bet contract. So for example, it could be 2. So what will happen is when I will create the my bet contract, the bet contract will be instantiated, and its constructor will receive this value 2. And so the value of bet type here will be 2. Okay, that is good. However, it could be the case that you might want to do this, but in a more dynamic way. So maybe that you do want to hard code these two values here, but what you want to do is to pass a value to the constructor of my bet and to forward this value to the constructor of the bet contract. So how could we do this? So first, let's get rid of those parentheses here. And the other way that you can you can pass value to the constructor of an inherited contract is in the constructor function of your contract. After the parenthesis, you can add the name of an inherited contract like this, as if it was a modifier, but this is not the case. And here you're going to pass a value to this constructor. So for example, we could say that we're going to pass the value contained in the variable bet type. But first, we need to define this bet type. So here in my bet constructor is going to be a uint bet type argument. So when I will instantiate the mybet contract, it will call the mybet constructor. This mybet constructor will receive this bet type value. This bet type value will be forwarded to the constructor of the bet contract because of this declaration. And now I will have a dynamic assignment of the bet type of the bet contract. That's it for today. I hope that now you know everything about contract inheritance in Solidity. For the next episode, we're going to study Remix, which is an IDE for developing Solidity smart contract. Bye-bye!